Judging by the weather, of course, fall is very near. Halloween is approaching. The pumpkins are finally ripe, and that means it is time for a trip to the pumpkin patch. And that is exactly where Christopher Lewis is on this October evening. That's Christopher? Right.
And you know, last week's rain kind of slowed up sales of pumpkins, but so far this season here, at least at the Carmichael place, there have been 15 truckloads of pumpkins in here. That amounts to about 40,000 pounds of them, and at 15 or 12 cents a pound, that's quite a bit of money coming in through here. But you know, when you get a whole bunch of pumpkins together with a whole bunch of kids, you get some very interesting things, Clayton, all about Halloween. Listen to this.
That's the name of the game here in Bixby, with pony rides, a small barnyard full of animals, and lots of scarecrows. It makes choosing a Halloween pumpkin a real treat, as these kids from the Broadway Baptist Kindergarten in Sand Springs soon found out.
Now, how can you tell a pumpkin?
I know.
Because
Listen. Oranges are orange, and oranges are round, and oranges have seeds in them.
I know, but
what's
pumpkins are bigger than oranges.
Pumpkins are bigger than oranges?
I know.
Yeah!
What do you do with pumpkins?
Eat them!
The whole thing?
No. Yeah!
That's how you make pumpkins
and jack-o'-lanterns with them.
And what time of year do pumpkins come out?
Halloween!
That's right. Now, this young man wasn't going to lug a huge vegetable around all day and pay 12 cents a pound for it. So to him, an apple would do just fine this Halloween. And in case you're bored with pumpkins by now, you can always climb a scarecrow in Bixby.
And also, you can search for your own pumpkin here. That's what all these brownies and Girl Scouts are doing. As a matter of fact, Carmichael's and the other produce farmers around Bixby that sell all the pumpkins this time of year are open just up until about 7 o'clock every night, and they say there are still some good pumpkins around if you haven't carved yours yet this year.
Chris, let's see yours.
Right here, Clayton. Isn't it beautiful? It's big. It's a little dirty because of all the rain this year, but I'm going to bring it back and see what we can do with it this year.
Okay, we'll be looking for it later on in the week.
Yes, we'll
Halloween
have a lot
approaches.
Of pumpkin pie for the rest of the week, too, I think.
Okay, Chris, thank you very much. Have a good time out there in the patch.
Thank you, sir.
Robert.
The Professor Irwin Corey of the That's Pumpkin
right.
Patch.
Yeah, we had those kids going.
A good afternoon to you, and welcome to our very final Tulsa Afternoon for Friday. Today is the 16th of September, 1983. We'll remember that date for a long time. I'm Christopher Lewis.
Oh, Jimmy, hold on. And I'm Beth Ringel. And do we have a great program to end our series today. To begin with, as you heard over in the corner, Jimmy Dean will be our special guest today. He's in town with the Roy Clark Celebrity Golf Classic. We'll get to talk with the championship golfer in a few minutes.
Yeah, Jimmy says his golfing is so good, he sings even better. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll find out why later on the show. Also, speaking of Roy Clark and the Classic, later on we're going to meet many of the famous guests who we've had with us this past year here on Tulsa Afternoon. Roy is one of them, of course. They're on tape, and it'll give you a chance to have one last look at some of the wonderful people who stopped by here during the past 12 months.
In the story department, we'll reintroduce you to our own Linda soundtrack.
Then, in honor of the Miss America pageant, which is coming up tomorrow night in Atlantic City, we're going to introduce you to Frank Gentry. He's a man who designs a lot of the evening gowns on Miss America contestants, and you'll find out how he does that later. All that plus Ramona Huffman with some news in the next hour, so stay with us. It's our final one here on Tulsa Afternoon, and to get this Friday rolling, let's talk about commercials with the ever-lovely Beth Ringel. And you'll remember yesterday we went to Eureka Springs, Arkansas on our travel day. Wasn't it fun there?
Oh, yeah.
You've
it's always
been
fun
before.
To go there. It's pretty.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
Very nice.
Going Arkansas. Back again today, huh?
We are going back again today. You're right. It was last summer that we first visited Eureka Springs to investigate reports that a real live turn-of-the-century wood-burning steam train was going through the Ozark Mountains near Eureka Springs. Those reports turned out to be true. It was the dream of a millionaire named Bob Dorch and one young boy who'd never ridden on a train before.
The Eureka Springs and North Arkansas Railroad, where at least for a few minutes, a young man's dream can come true.
Now that that railroad keeps on growing over there in Eureka Springs. We called there today, and now you can take a 4-mile round trip in just about 45 minutes. It's not the fastest railroad in the country, but you got to agree, it's certainly one of the prettiest, one of the most quaint. And we've got plenty next on the afternoon show. We've got a lot coming up, including a champion golfer. Ladies and gentlemen, you know him for singing, you know him for comedy, but he's really a great golfer. Is his name Jimmy Dean?
I'm going to warp you in the head with a wet squirrel.
We'll be back to get warped.
You'll be an ornery just because you're getting fired. You wouldn't be that nasty if you had work.
We'll be back in 2 minutes, we hope. Jimmy, before we go, I got to ask you one question.
Yes, sir.
Because of all the things you've done in showbiz, is there anything that you haven't done that you want to do in the future?
Raquel Welch.
Raquel Welch. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, you heard it first here on Tulsa Afternoon.
You're a terrible guy.
We're going out in style. Okay. Thanks a million for Jimmy. Thanks a million
for
doing
it.
You
bet. It's my pleasure.
You're a good man.
To see you again.
Thank you, Jimmy. Best of luck to both of you, you lovely, talented people,
and I know you'll have no trouble getting well.
Well, we might. Okay. We're going to see you all in 2 minutes on Tulsa Afternoon, because when we come back, we're not only going to take a trip to meet a rent-a-husband, but Ramona Huffman will be here. Rent-a-husband, you got it. And Ramona will be here with news, so don't go away.